in today, there's almost an expectation for any credible business to have an online presence, especially a website. With your website, you can be present online 24/7, and potential customers will definitely find you whenever they look for you. And at its simplest, your website acts as an information exchange medium where you can connect with your customers. So you can connect with your customers, you can receive their feedbacks, you can facilitate inquiries, and you can definitely market your products or your services with a website. But before you jump into building a website for your business, I want to share with you 5 questions that you need to ask and answer correctly. Hey guys, my name is Fusayo Patrick, and in today's video I'm going to be talking about 5 questions you need to ask yourself before building a website for your business. Let's get right into it. Number 1, what is the nature of my business? So here, what I would say is that you do a mini elevator pitch to kind of summarize what you do in your business, okay? And this summary is what must be immediately obvious when people land on your website. So for instance, if you are a designer and you make branded t-shirts and you want to sell them with your website, when people come onto your website, it must be obvious that that is what you do. You need to, because you have few seconds to catch people's attention. So once they land on your website, they need to immediately understand that yes, you are a designer who makes branded t-shirts and you sell quality branded t-shirts. And you know, whatever goal you have for your business will be easily met. And that takes me to the second point. What are the goals for your website? So some people use their website as a communication tool to communicate with their audience. Some people use it as a marketing tool to market their product, to market their service. Some people use it simply to boost brand visibility, and others, especially bloggers, use it to share their blog post and get people to buy whatever they are selling. So whatever it is you want to achieve with your website, you need to sit down and first identify it and be sure, so that in the web building process, if you are building yourself or if you're giving it to an expert, this goal needs to be met. You need to build your website in the way that the goals you have for it will be met. Number 3, who are my target audience? So before you make any decisions in your business, you need to have your target audience in mind. You need to always have your target audience in mind before you make any business decision, okay? Because you are building this website for them, right? You want it to appeal to them. You want them to find it usable. You're not building a website for yourself. You're not building the website because you want to feel good about yourself, okay? You need to always have your target audience in mind when you are building your website. So you need to figure out who your target audience is. Now, you sell branded t-shirts. Who are those likely to buy branded t-shirts? Are they millennials? Are they adults? Are they secondary school students? Are they employers who want to, you know, use it as a marketing tool? They want to make branded t-shirts for their employees to wear around. Whoever your target audience is, you need to figure it out. And you need to make sure that your website appeals to them. Number 4. Who are my competitors? So when I was building my website, I'm a freelancer and I'm in the branding industry. So I checked a whole lot of freelance branding, bloggers that talk about branding, freelancers, and I saw what they were talking about. I saw that they were more particular about their blog and they had a website too. So their major focus was on their blog. So that was what I did. I started with a blog and thereafter I built it into a full website. So I knew that my target audience are people that like to read stuff, people that wanted to build their blogs. So they will need to read, people that wanted to build their brands rather. So they will need to read blogs on building their brands. So you need to figure out who your competitors are. So knowing how my competitors were doing their own websites helped me to build my own website, and you know, it was a seamless process. So you need to figure out who your competitors are. Then number 5, what are my core values? Having a core values for your business will guide your web design process. They will guide you when you're coming up with features for your website. They will guide you when you're talking to your designer on the content to put. They will guide you when you're talking to your content writer. They'll guide you when you're talking to your designer. So for instance, my core values are speed, honesty, finance, and I can't remember right now, and innovation. So I make sure that I'm using the latest trends. I make sure that things are simplified for my audience. I make sure that It is innovative and not complicated. So knowing what your core values are will help you make the right decisions when building your website. So those are five questions that you need to ask yourself. And now others include what are your brand colors, what's your preferred domain name, have you had a website before, and so on. So in the description of this video, I put a link to the onboarding form that I sent to my clients when I'm about to build a website for them. You can definitely check it out and, you know, steal my ideas, use it to answer questions when you're about to build your website. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and don't forget to follow me on social media, @FisayoPatrick1. Bye.